Yo, y'all know what it is. Y'all know the time we've been waiting for. I had to repost this because the other one, I don't know what happened, but we're gonna redo this again. It's the Chicago Bears win-loss prediction for their record for this season. Y'all know the pieces we added: Caleb Williams, everybody else. Y'all know. You know what I'm saying? Vegas projecting us at about 9 wins last I checked, which is fair. It's a 500 record. It's better than before. Long as we keep getting better each season, you take that. So with our record, we have the 10th easy, I mean the third easiest schedule in the league. We don't play a divisional game till week 11, so that's good. That's something great that we could, you know, that we have to look forward to. That's in our favor for the season. Now on to the picks. All four preseason games is nationally televised. I have a video on that one. I can let y'all check it out in the description in your own entirety. So, that's pretty much the news on that one. But you know, Hall of Fame game against the Houston Texans, who we also play in the season. But let's get right on to these picks. For week one, we got the Tennessee Titans. Things just got amped a little bit because all pro defensive tackle Jeffrey Simmons literally said he can't wait to face the Chicago Bears because of Caleb Williams. So he can say painted nails. You know, everybody wants to get to that. They want to get under his skin. Caleb Williams got the pretty boy image, light skin, this and that. They think he Hollywood playing over there in California, which is cool. You expect that, especially he's a rookie. You want to get under his head because you know the talent, so you want to get to him. Out of Houston, this is a good matchup because the Bears and, I said Houston, Bears and Tennessee both have up-and-coming quarterbacks. Caleb Williams plays for us. Will Levis plays for Tennessee Titans. This is his second year in the league. They have a nice up front seven on defense, front four, front seven. But their weakness for years has been their secondary, and I think that'll be the key matchup here. Y'all know who the Bears have: DJ Moore, who's going to be looking for an extension. We just got Keenan Allen, and we drafted Rome Odunze, and we have tight end Cole Kmet. So, and we got Swift out the backfield. So, with that, I think that the Bears will get the W. They will start off the season 1-0 against Tennessee, you know, and defend home court, home field, my fault. Moving on to week two, we've got the Houston Texans. This is a primetime game. We go to Houston. Y'all know the story with them, Super Bowl contenders this year. Y'all know who they've added to the roster. They've got Stephon Diggs, they've got Joe Mixon. So they've added these pieces. Y'all know what they did last year. They had CJ Stroud, who had arguably the greatest rookie season of all time. Was it 26 touchdowns, 5 interceptions, or something like that? So y'all know the weapons there. This is Caleb Williams' first primetime game of his career, Sunday Night Football. I have the Bears losing. We probably will make it interesting, more than likely. But in the end, I think we will lose that game. Because Texans are a better team. At least right now, they're a better team. And there's no shame in that. But, you know, everybody's going to be gone. It's going to be a lot of commotion, blah, blah, blah. This, that, and the third. This team is this. This team is that. Which you expect. And it's fine. You know what I'm saying? The world's not going to fall over or any of that. The world's not going to end. We're just going to lose a football game to a better team. So I got us at 1-1. Moving on to week three, we have Indianapolis Colts. This game is in Indianapolis. Another game, two up and coming, three straight games with two up and coming potential quarterbacks. Anthony Richardson, y'all seen the potential. Y'all know he's like a linebacker out there playing quarterback at 6'5", about 240. Can run, can throw, he can do all that. Season was cut short due to injury, but y'all see the potential. Excuse me, y'all see the talent is there. Caleb Williams, y'all know what he do. The Colts, they have a pretty decent roster. Jonathan Taylor, the wide receiver. Oh, what's his name? Oh, what's the guy's name? Y'all know what I'm talking about. Junior. Michael. y'all know who I'm talking about. The tight end for the Colts, wide receiver for the Colts. He's like a tight end. He's like 6'5". I think his first name, Michael. Y'all know what I'm talking about. But anyways, him. So they got some pretty good weapons. But I think the Bears take the win in this one. I think so. We start off the season 2-1 after three. I think we beat the Colts. We go to Indianapolis in a tight one. Week four, we go against the Rams in Chicago. Still going to be pretty warm out September. So weather won't be too much of a factor. Plus, they have a quarterback in Matthew Stafford who's used to playing in Soldier Field anyway. No Aaron Donald, so that certainly helps us. But I think the Rams take the W. So we start off the season at 2-2 at the four games. Moving on to week five. Oh, and, you know, the Rams got their weapons. I think that's going to be a bit much for us. I stated that in my other video that's no longer here. But moving on to week five. Week five, we go against the Panthers. This should be a win. This should be an extra bye week. No disrespect. We've been raping the Panthers. They pretty much turned our franchise. We beat them the last two times we played them. They pretty much turned our franchise around. We've got Caleb Williams out the deal. We've got Darnell Wright. We've got Tyreek Stevenson. We got DJ Moore, of course, and we still got one more pick to get. And they got Bryce Young, who I think can be a really good quarterback, just in a terrible situation. So that's that with that situation. Nothing much to discuss. We should beat the Panthers. We should be 3-2 at this point. I expect us to. So that's a win in Chicago. Moving on to week six. We have our second primetime game, but this is in London. Y'all, against the Jaguars, 8:30 in the morning. Y'all know London is basically like the Jags' second home. It can go either way. Bears fans like to travel. We can get the W. Y'all know Trevor Lawrence just got that extension. I think it was $275 million for 5 years. But I'm going to say we lose this one and start off 3-3. Bears could win, but I'm going to say we lose this one. We lose to the Jags. They play pretty well out there in London. It's like a second home for them. So I'm going to say we start off 3-3 after six, which is pretty damn good. 500 record. Next week, we play the Washington Commanders. This is the battle of the number one and number two overall picks. And Jaden Daniel and Caleb Williams. I think the Bears take the W here. We should beat them. We beat them last year, which was our first win on primetime. But I think we get the W here. It's a noon game in Washington. We should beat them. Yeah, so the Bears should get that W. They got some pretty good weapons, though. Austin Eckler. Who else? They added somebody else. We all know they got Terry McLaurin. A few other pieces they added. But overall, we should beat the Commanders. Moving on to week nine. We play the Cardinals. We beat them last year. This is a 3:05 p.m. game. We beat them last year. Y'all know they extended Kyler Murray. Well, they plan to. At least. Well, they've been extending them, but they kept him, should I say. They didn't go for a quarterback. They drafted the other generational talent in Marvin Harrison Jr. So Marvin Harrison, you know, he's been having a shaky offseason with some news as far as endorsements, etc. But on the field, he's an absolute animal, absolute stud. I mean, just a guy you create on Madden. So he's probably going to be looking for a bit of revenge against the Bears for not drafting him. He might be holding a grudge a little bit. But I think we should beat him. I think the Bears should beat the Cardinals. I think we should win this game in Arizona. Moving on. So we're at 5-3. Moving on. We play the Patriots. A noon game in Chicago. We beat them 2 years ago. We played them on primetime. Big win. Nobody had us winning. This is against the third overall pick in the draft. So two of those three games in that span, we play the second and third overall pick in the draft. So we play Drake May, who is the brother, you know what I'm saying? Drake May, y'all know his brother, played for North Carolina as well. So this should be a pretty good game. I think the Bears should get, I expect Drake May to start. I don't know if he's starting off. No, I think he is going to start off as a starter. But they've got drafted two guys. They drafted the quarterback in the sixth round for Tennessee, too, who could be a sneaky pick. So Patriots might have did pretty well with their drafting. But we play him in week 10. Patriots, Week 10, yes. No longer Bill Belichick. He's not there. Y'all know how he did usually against rookie quarterbacks or young quarterbacks. Y'all know he usually have their number, but he's not there. Tom Brady's not there. The Bears should get the W. We should be sitting at 6-3 at this point. Now, moving on to week 11 against the Packers, Soldier Field. Noon game. This is our first game of the year. Not prime time, but in the division. I think the Bears have a more talented roster than the Packers. But I feel like the Packers roster is better built. And that's the trenches. O-line, D-line, I think the Bears are catching up, but I think they're a little better. And this is where I give them the major edge, at least for now. Coaching. And I think that's why we're going to lose week 11. I think the Packers are going to beat us. Hate to say it. I hope I'm wrong. I think the Packers are going to snap our, three-game win streak. And that'll be our first divisional game and loss of the season. So I think the Packers are going to get us in that one. It's going to be a lot of commotion. Oh, we still own you, this, and that. Lose 11 straight to Matt LaFleur and all that. Okay, cool, blah, blah, blah. Let them have their fun. I hope I'm wrong, but I think that's how it's going to play out. We got to be realistic here. Moving on to week 12, we have another divisional game, a chance to bounce back against the Minnesota Vikings. Vikings are a team everybody's expecting to finish last, and I actually, looking at their roster, I think they're going to be actually pretty competitive and pretty good. I might make a separate video on the Vikings. This game is at Soldier Field. You know, they've got Aaron Jones, who constantly killed the Bears. They've got Sam Darnold, who I'm very high on. Think he's one of the best passers in the league as far as throwing the football. In the league, I think you get him in the right situation, which is here. J.J. McCarthy, I've never thought he would be a great NFL player. I still stand on that. I see A.J. McCarron-type ceiling. But with the right system, he can be right. Now you're playing with the best wide receiver in football and then arguably potential a top 10 wide receiver in Jordan Addison. Y'all know, obviously, the first one was Justin Jefferson. But I think the Vikings can make it very interesting, but you're going to take this L. The Bears are going to beat you, and we're going to be sitting at 8-3, if I'm correct. Yes, if I'm correct, we'll be sitting at 8-3 at this point. Yes. No, 7-3. I think 7-3. 7-4. I want to say 7-4. I'll find an end. Moving on, we have the Lions on Thanksgiving. That's three straight divisional games. Lions on Thanksgiving, so that's another primetime game. So far, the Bears are 0-2 in primetime games. Can we get our first win? No. I think the Lions will beat us in week 13. So don't get it twisted. We could very well sweep the Lions. We could dominate them because we did last year. We were an historic sweep away, a historic choke job away, my fault, from sweeping them. With a better roster, upgrades across, what makes you think it could be any different? But I think we lose this one. I think the Lions will come hungry. They will feed off the crowd. I was there at the draft. That record set night at the draft, I was there. Y'all know my ties. People who know me know I have ties in Detroit, too. I was actually born in Michigan, but I moved back over here to Chicago when I was 2. You know, where my family was originally from. You know, it's a long story for another day. Y'all don't care about me. Y'all care about hearing about these teams, right? So I think we lose to Detroit. I think we're sitting at 8-5, 7-5, but I'll know in a second. Next week, I think 8-5. We play the San Francisco 49ers. 3:25 game, which suits the West Coast time. Caleb Williams goes back to California. The Niners are our team. We trade wins with every year. We've been trading wins with them every year. So we play them very tough. A lot of people don't know that. They might be Super Bowl contenders, but it's certain teams you match up well. For us, it's the 49ers. Do I think we get the W? No, I think the Niners get us in this one. Caleb Williams will play fairly decent back at home, but it won't be enough to get the win because the Niners are just simply a better team. So I think the Niners beat us in that one. Christian McCaffrey, Madden cover, y'all know. Y'all know the roster they have. So moving on. George Kittle is going to come to the Bears soon. Y'all know your Bears are moving on. Once again, we get another chance to make up with a bounce-back win against the Minnesota Vikings. This is on Monday Night Football in Minnesota. Now, we beat them last year on primetime. I don't remember if it was Monday night Thursday night or Sunday night. I think Thursday, but I don't remember. We beat them last year on primetime. It was Monday, I think. I think it was Monday. Monday or Thursday. I don't think it was Sunday. We beat them last year. Y'all know that Justin Fields drive, 33-yard strike to DJ Moore, the game-winning field goal. We play the Vikings. I told you about the Vikings. They have a pretty decent roster. I've been in between whether we split or whether we sweep them. But I'm going to go ahead on and say we sweep the Vikings and beat them in this one to get a bounce back. We're going to be angry. We're going to lose two straight against the Lions and the 49ers, which was two teams that was in the NFC Championship game. So there's no shame in that. We're going to beat the Vikings. You beat the teams you're supposed to beat, and this is how we're going to do it. Moving on, week 16, we get a rematch against the Lions at Soldier Field. And this is where I think we get our bounce back win in the cold. We might even dominate them. We might even dominate the Lions. Jared Goff is terrible in the cold. So the Bears are going to get their bounce back win. It's going to be a pretty good convincing win too. So we're going to beat them. Moving on. Week 17, Thursday night football. Another primetime game. Can we get our second primetime win? Can we ride off the momentum and get three straight wins and two straight primetime wins against the Seattle Seahawks, also said Supersonics. Yes, we will. We will beat the Sonics, and this will be our 10th win of the season. So, yes, we're sitting at 10-6 right now. So, we're going to beat the Seahawks. No, 10-5. No, 10-6. 10-6. We're going to beat the Seahawks. No more Pete Carroll. No more Shane Waldron. He's actually with us, so he's going to know them pretty well. I'm not worried about Geno Smith or any of them. Geno Smith might just go back to the Geno Smith of old without Shane Waldron and Pete Carroll. So we're going to beat them. That should definitely be a win in Chicago. Now, moving on, season finale. Right now, it's slated for a 12 o'clock game, but this is against the Packers in week 18 at Lambeau. So it's going to be cold out there. Y'all know it's going to be cold. It's going to be lit. Could be playoff as indications, whatever. We don't know, but all I know is the Bears, I predict them to be sitting at 10-6 at this point. And we will go 11-6 as we will break the streak and finally beat Matt LaFleur and the Packers to knock them off. What would that do for the season? Would that be to win the division? We don't know. Would that be to clinch a wild card? We don't know. Would that just be a win for bragging rights? We don't know. But we're going to win. That's my prediction. So I got the Bears slated at 11-6. Losses to the Jaguars in London, the Texans in Houston, Packers at Soldier Field, Lions in Detroit, who's the other loss? San Francisco in California, and a loss to the Rams in Chicago. Those are the six losses I have. The rest, I think, will be wins. I'm iffy on, I can see 10-7 maybe with a split with the Vikings. We split all across the division. I don't know. But I expect the Bears to at least be a wild card at worst, but I expect a pretty good season from us. But that's my take. What y'all think? What y'all think about the Bears season? How do y'all think y'all season? If you're a fan of a different team, what record do you predict for your team? Where do y'all think I went wrong with the wins and losses? Let me know which ones y'all think was correct, incorrect. Let me know some in the comments. But that's it. Like, share, subscribe if you're new, and we out.